Hey everyone, I am Izzy Noodles. Welcome to Aqua Sanctuary. So we start off by sliding down there. And right here in the corner, there's not a lot to do right now, but here there is this door, but we need a crowbar for that. So we're going to have to come back to here later. So just hop down into the gap and follow the path and you'll get a wicked flyby. So this area is actually quite big. You see a shotgun there, that's a hint that that's what we want. That's actually going to trigger an event. So that's the first thing we'll do. But this area is actually really tall. Okay, so just hop up and we are just going to go straight to that shotgun. So this is a fairly easy game to do without using meds. That is up until you get to the boss, and wow, it does it become quite a challenge. It really does. So anyway, you're just looking for that gap in the ledge. That's the only way we can start to climb. So come all the way to Lara's right, because you're slightly higher just here, and then just jump forward and grab. And then to here. So you just run and jump to there, and here's the shotgun. So before I pick that up, I'm gonna save because, as I said, it triggers an event. So it actually triggers an enemy. There it is. So I always hop down so he can't get me, and you want him to go left. Please go left. This way. Oh, it's already going badly. But yeah, there is no there he is. There's no controlling his animations. He missed me anyway, so that's fine. His animations are so random. There he is. Come here. So when you do get a good lock on, where he's not potentially going to shoot at you. Yeah, they take a few shots, so you're going to be here a while. Excuse me. Come from behind there, please. There we go. Oh, it's sometimes difficult for Lara to actually lock on. For goodness sake, what are you doing? Please, stop. So we've got a lock. Oh, I think that was a good one because he shot, but it was in a position where Lara was not going to get hit. So when that happens, that's very good. Excuse me, could you like just stay in one place, please? We're off to a very bad start. Well, he's walking into that wall, so. He's only done that once while I've been practicing. Lara won't even target him. Not cool. Oh, for goodness sake, I might reload. Oh, she's targeting. That's fine. So, while I'm shooting him, I will explain that sometimes you can get into a position where he shoots a beam, or whatever you're going to call it. And it hits the wall, or it hits the ledge where Lara is standing, it hits underneath there. So Lara is perfectly safe. Or if you're fast enough, you can try and run down and you can actually squat right under him and not take damage. So he has dropped an item. I will run down and grab that. So just for getting down here, for the sake of your health, just run forward and grab in the air, and you'll slide straight into that gap. Okay. So he has dropped a guardian key. We want two of these right now, so here is one. And you actually just want to go into the room where he came from. We can go in there now because it is now open. Quite obviously, because that's where he came from. Duh. Climb up. And this lever that you see here will open the other door. And then the other guardian will come out. So I'm going to save just in case. Okay, there we go. Oh, wow, he was fast. Where did he go? He usually lingers in the doorway. He's the other way. So you want to get up to him as fast as you can and duck down. I'm a bit low. Oh, that's fine. Perfect. That's why I wanted to rush up to him. So you can duck down and you won't get hit. Even better if he's higher than you are. As I said, it does take some time. Yep, takes some time. There we go. Oh, he fell right on top of Lara. Ouch. So here we go. Here is our second guardian key. Oh, just while I'm here, I nearly forgot. I'm going to point out. Oh, hang on. No, this is where I want to be. So never mind. While I'm here, it's because he comes from the other door. I usually run up to him, but he went the wrong way. Lost my bearings. But anyway, this is where we want to place the guardian keys. So just climb the pole and jump back where we pulled that lever. And you can go even higher. It's a bit tricky and it's not very obvious. Oh, wrong way. Okay, so I sometimes struggle with this jump. If you see there, you can jump to that higher ledge there. So I'm going to save because I do struggle with this. Not particularly difficult, it's just me, but that was pretty good. And here is a ladder we can climb. So go up as far as it will allow you. And there is a slope, so you want to hold the jump button so she'll jump back. And keep holding it because there is another slope right there. Love the mechanics in this. Not as simple as you think it's going to be, but not over the top difficult. It's awesome. Okay, so flares, and you can see there and over there, that's where we're going to put the guardian keys. So run and jump and grab to slide along in. Oh, didn't need to jump back then. So just jump back to here in order to reach the other gap. Same again, and here we go. Place the second key. So the block behind, the yellow block that was in the middle here, has now gone. It lowered and we can press this button. And this is the area where we were. I said that it was a really tall area, so don't be confused. I was the first time I played. I thought it was a brand new area. But no, it's exactly where we were. So from here, I tend to do the fake grab right there. Oh my goodness. Well, not like that, because that was rubbish. Okay, so I mentioned the fake grab that I failed quite spectacularly on. So before she grabs, you want to stop holding down the grab button, so just jump back and grab, but then let go. That's how it's done. And to avoid unnecessary damage, just shimmy closer to the pole, because then you've got that slightly raised bit just there, and Lara will not take damage. So, you see, this is the same area, all full of water now. So that's what we did. We filled it all with water. And the reason I will get to in a moment, I wanted to show you this pot here, because if you interact with it, you can grab it, but you can't actually push it. She just won't push or pull. And you can see we can get in that room because there is a lever. So obviously we need to be there. So just grab this med pack that's here, and now we will figure this out. So just hop into the water now that we have water. I mean, you may have already spotted this door. This door can only be opened with water. It's an underwater door. Very sneaky. Quite clever. And you've got this lever. The camera angle always changes, so you don't actually see what it does. So it's actually right here. It's opened this hatch, but you don't ever see it open because the very first time I played, I saw what it did, which I'm quite glad for because I probably would not have guessed it's right there. But yeah, you can't see it because the angle changes. But now we're on the other side of this pot. Awesome stuff. And now we can push it out the way. And it is sometimes difficult to get out of here. There we go. Simple enough. So just give this pot a shove. Now we've got easy access to this room, but we still need to pull that lever there, but we can't now because we've opened the trap door. But now we have easy access, or we can actually go back into the water and pull this lever again. I love this puzzle. Some of these puzzles are genius. They're simple, but they are genius. So just swim out. And look at that. Look, we can now enter the room. So pull it, and that will help us climb higher in the room. It raises some platforms there. So now we're going to start climbing. So you're looking for your gap in the ledge again, where we climbed up the very first time. Here we are. And I'm just going to say that sometimes you need to possibly save your game more often than you think, because you do make some silly mistakes, just as I did when I fell down. So it's often easy to forget to save, and then you have to redo loads of stuff. So I'm just gonna point that out. You can usually run and jump to there, but I think I was at an angle. So I was a bit too close to the ledge to jump to this one. But anyway, I'm not gonna continue to climb just yet. You can see near that skeleton there is a med pack, so I'm just gonna run over to there. I say run, it's more of a jump, really. So you've got just enough space to stand in this corner by this pot, and I recommend just taking a little shimmy to the side just to guarantee that you will grab the side of this. And small med pack. Whoa! Ooh-hoo. Just in time grab. Don't know why I climbed up, because I need to shimmy back. Okay, and from here you can just grab that ledge where you jumped from. You actually want to aim a little bit more to the right and just veer left a bit. It's a tricky jump because this damn plant, and also it's just at an angle, so it is odd. So I'm gonna save just for that reason. I know I've just saved, but who cares? I don't. Okay, so jump forward and veer to the left. Not always easy. Okay, so that is the reason I saved. It's a tricky jump. Awesome. Okay, so yeah, tricky. Wire saved. Deal with it. And now, before I continue on up, I will just come to the other side and grab a secret. So, same again, you've got just enough space to stand there, and I often am able to just run past that pot right there. Awesome stuff. And you can jump and grab here because there is a crack in the other side. You see here what I mean by a crack in the other side? And in this gap, you need to often press the crawl button to climb into some of these gaps, is our first secret. So it feels as though it's been a while since I've played a game, Tomb Raider specifically. That might be obvious. It's been a while since I've played one where you don't get a secret at the very start. Not a problem. It played on my mind when I first picked it up. I was like, oh, look at that. Bit different. But I think a lot of people want to take that from Tomb Raider 3. You got three secrets right at the very start. But anyway, you've got a crack in this ledge as well, which means you can run to it. I said ledge, it's more of a column, but you can grab that. So that's an easy peasy way back. And here we go. So we have our first secret, and now I am going to climb on up. Some of these are annoying when you've got the slope. You can only just stand at one point because she turns a lot. And this can be a bit odd as well, so I'm going to save. Like sometimes she doesn't jump over that. She did today. And I've also had a bug where I've activated these platforms, but they're not up for some reason, but they're just invisible, and you can stand on the empty spot. So don't panic there. And I've also had a bug where they are up, but you just fall straight through them, which was actually incredibly annoying. So, be persistent. My B's and P's today. There's always something. But anyway, just climb up there, and you might need to keep readjusting yourself. Because that's what happened to me the first time I played. And take a left after climbing up. You see, you've got that little ledge platform on the wall there. So we need to raise it. And yes, it's timed. Oh, come on now. So jump onto here. Running, jump, and jump, and fail. Awesome. So it doesn't give you long, but it is pretty simple. Oh, please, Lara. Please. I'm trying to run and jump and turn. There we go. Why? I'm failing so hard today. Oh, Lara. Oh. Oh, for goodness sake. All right, that's how it should be done. Took a few more attempts than it should have done. I usually just get that on the first go. Not today. Not today. But anyway, from here, you see the crack in the ledge, so just jump forward and grab. Shimmy all the way along. And when you get to this column, you want to be all the way to the left here because you've only got a small gap to stand in, and she might climb into the gap and just fall off because she doesn't have enough room. So you want to be right here in order to stand. Just jump to here, and I'm gonna go get another secret. which is over this way, and it's pretty darn difficult. So I'm going to save, obviously. So this one is probably the hardest secret to get to. You need to do a banana jump around, but you don't want to be too close to that pillar right there. You want to aim a bit more right than what you think. So approximately where I am might be a bit trial and error. I know it certainly will for me. Let's just see how it goes. Yep. So you do want to try and grab that, just so you know. Whoa now, look at that, second attempt. That's actually a world record for me. But anyway, here, just in this gap, this is our secret. And it's fantastic that you do get really awesome goodies in the secret. Sir, plural. So you get lots of ammo. And usually a large health pack. Sometimes it's only a single health pack, but at least it will be a large one. But if you do get ammo, you get plenty of ammo. Okay, so from here, you've got the crack in the ledge where we have already been to. You'll want to just run forward and grab, and you'll slide straight in and do the same again where you grab this and shimmy along. Okay. Oh, I'm not far enough. Nope. Okay. Well, that's what happens. Now you see why you have to be all the way to the side. There we go. Oh, didn't mean to go around. But you have to be all the way to the end and then climb up. So back to here. And now let's continue this way. So you can stand and jump here, but there is a slope, oh my goodness. Okay, so I just grabbed there to stop that, and she just grabbed, so that's fine. That's never happened before. So you've got a low ceiling, so just be aware of that. You might need to be all the way to the right and then climb up. And shotgun shells here. So that's, if you want the shotgun shells, this is the best opportunity to get them, because we've got a trap here and it's not easy to come back. So there is a way to not take damage. It's not 100% successful. You might need to keep readjusting. That camera angle usually changes for me, so I'm on the other side of the blades. But never mind, I can deal with this. I'm gonna save. There is lots of saving in this. You want to just have the blades to Lara's side and just side flip and perfect. So it's not 100% all the time, but just keep adjusting, realigning, take a step forward, take a step back, blah blah blah, and you'll eventually get it. So we've activated that skeleton. When we come forward, he's waiting. Going to equip my shotgun. So it usually takes two shots for this guy. Sometimes I've only had it once or twice. You can actually shoot him off the ledge from here, but I don't want to just keep wasting bullets. Oh, he nearly got me. Oh, he's gone. Nice. Awesome. So what I didn't mention is that we're climbing up to get to the next area. So this will open the gate. There's the gate. So that's actually just right there. Oh! I did not mean to do that. At least I didn't die, but I'm certainly going to reload. Alright, floor switch. I actually used 3 shots on the skeleton this time. Don't actually need that. Wrong button. And to get down, there is a safe route, which is back the way you came, across here. And you see that large med pack? Just in the window, just about see it down below. That's the safe way down, which I would never have thought of. You actually just want to run forward and grab in the air to slide straight into the gap. Amazing. Sometimes it's not so easy though. There will be a lot of saving for no reason, but deal with it. Sorry, not sorry. There we go. Okay, so hop down safely. So awesome. Come through the door and a brand new area with brand new flyby. So the flyby makes this area look really big. It's actually really easy to navigate. It doesn't take long to figure this area out. So you saw an obelisk right there. There are 4 gems to collect in this area that you want to place in the obelisk. So it's pretty easy to navigate. It's not as big as the flyby makes it look. Okay, so firstly, on the left-hand side, there are some oozy clips right here. And on the opposite side, come all the way over, come in to this doorway, just gonna equip my pistols. Because, oh no, oh, they got me. They got me. I think that'll be okay though. It's only a tiny bit. Anyway, in here, you've got a laser sight. And opposite, there are some arrows. So, we will be getting a crossbow. And that's what these coloured blocks here are for. We need a crossbow for those, but obviously we don't have one yet, so we can't do this puzzle just yet. So I mentioned we'll be getting 4 gems, and I will be getting 2 of those gems in this video. So puzzle number 1, here we are. You've got these pillars here and levers above them. You've got 2 blocks that you can move and 4 dark spots on the ground. So you can't move, you know, have something on all 4 spots at the same time. So you have to figure this one out. It's actually really easy peasy. So firstly, take this block and push it onto this first spot. So each spot corresponds with the pillar that's right in front of it. And they will all show you what they've done. So just try and get behind to give it a push. Okay, so that's let us go higher up there, but we need to raise the block on this one to actually reach the lever. The levers are actually really high on all of the pillars. So move this to the second spot. Let's go in front of it. Okay, so now we can easily pull that first lever. There are 3 levers to pull. Okay, so just a simple run and jump and grab, and a first lever. So that's shown as a gate, but Tomb Raider logic tells us that if it's shown you a gate and it doesn't do anything, you have got to do more stuff. So obviously, three levers, pull them all, the gate will open. So you want also might want to keep saving, because hopping down you might just fall or take a little bit of damage, and we don't want that. And also, if you have to reload, you've got to push all the blocks again. Annoying. But anyway, from here I'm going to push this second block onto the third spot. Awesome, so that's raised the next one. So just run up again, jump to that one. I think this is possibly the most long-winded one, but that's fine. We can deal with that. Oh, don't need to grab for that because that block is lower than it was. Next lever. Okay, so still nothing, so obviously another lever to pull. And I will actually save, because these blocks can be, well, they're not tedious to get down from, but sometimes I fall. Okay, so you can easily just do a standing jump to each block. I know I said it can sometimes be tedious, but sometimes I find it tedious. Deal with it. So anyway, now we're at the bottom. We've got the second block on the third space, and we actually want to keep that one there. Otherwise we can't reach the last one. So we want to move this first one all the way into the last position. Alright, so now, last one, are you just hopping along to, you know, to the last one. Awesome, so before you pull this, you want to make sure you've equipped your shotgun, because once you pull it, we will spawn a couple of harpies. So make sure you've got that. Also, saving. Because when you're being shot at, it is especially tedious to try and get down. So that's open. Just walk to the edge and you can jump. Oh. Okay, just do your best. Did I mention they are poisonous? Oh, fantastic. Okay, that's a brilliant amount of damage to not take. I don't know, how would you say that? But that's a good amount of damage to have right now. That's actually really good. So it can be tedious to get down and shoot at them at the same time. So, here is our first aqua gem. Awesome. So it really doesn't matter what order you get these in. I mean, obviously, like I said before, you need the crossbow for that one puzzle. So you obviously can't do that one just yet. Also over here, let me just point out, there is a lever on the floor, but we need a crowbar for that one. Which, once we get it, it deactivates the spikes on that platform where there is a key. Once we get the key, we can open that door. None of this is relevant right now, but I'm just pointing out that it's there. Just so you know. So anyway, for now we're done in this lower section. My goodness, Lara, could you just please... Hey, there you go. You got it. Okay. So if I just look, there you go. You can see the key on that platform there. And you can jump to here and look, new place. Well, not a new place, it's all one area, but higher up. So right now, because you've got a cave over there and you've got this over here, I'm going to go straight forward for the moment. Also, a hint, in this deeper water, you can sprint right through it. But I hit a wall and stopped sprinting, so now she's not sprinting. Another hint, if she wades on these higher parts, just jump up and she will change her animation and start running. Slightly annoying. But, oh my goodness, too many buttons being pressed. But there's the gate where we've got our next aqua gem. And let me just show you this. You see that raises those blocks, and you've got this one. And that lowers the blocks. You also see that jump switch, the third one to the left. That's an issue with the blocks up, because you can't pull it with the blocks up. But you want them up to be able to actually get up there. So once we're up there, we will figure this out. So just for now, ignore the jump switch and start climbing up. So you see, this is why we want them up, we want to be on them. But you just can't interact with the jump switch. So from here, you can only go to this window ledge. And if we have a look, we can actually jump to this column. So we're actually just going around the outside to make your way along to where we want to be, which is back inside. So once we get to the end, there's a higher ledge. You can't see it very well. Just on the right hand side, you can see a waterfall. We want to be there. There is a lever and it will raise this fancy looking block right there. So once I've triggered that, you might be able to tell why we've done that. I mean, this section is actually quite long-winded. So it's all about the running and jumping as well. So you might be better off saving every so often, just in case you fall off, which is exactly what I'm going to do. Potentially fall off and definitely save. You know, one of both worlds. Best of both worlds. Dunno, I'm just rambling today, dunno why. So this slope can be tedious. You might grab this ledge after the slope, you might not. But anyway, that's one reason to save. Making your way along, and there's the lever that we want. So this will raise that block. And to get down without taking any damage, you want to be on the right hand side of this indent in the ground, because the water is slightly deeper. So you won't take any damage here, but you might actually take damage on those higher little bits because there is less water on them. I know, it's quite clever, like real life logic. So just climb onto this so the platforms go down, and you might have figured it out. So now those are down, we're coming to this new block that we raised. Yeah, did you get it? Did you see it yet? So now we're making our way to the jump switch. Don't actually need to line yourself up there because she has plenty of room to just jump. Okay, so now we can just do a standing jump to the jump switch. Do you see what the point of that was? We raised the block, so we don't have to have these platforms raised. You can do a standing jump. Running jump or standing jump, they'll both work. Awesome, so there is our gem. Second aqua gem. Also, be careful right here. Don't go running on in because you've got a spike trap on the ground. So it might be trial and error for how close you need to be. And you just want to simply do a side jump. Perfect. Here we go. And now you've activated them, you can just run straight on over. And I said that I was just going to get two gems in this video, but before I end the video, I'm just going to go grab a secret. So what we want to do, we want to make our way back to the jump switch. Didn't mean to jump back. Okay, so just run to the ledge here, but not actually to the jump switch. This is where you want to be. You want to come as forward as you can because you want to just jump up to the ledge. Just jump and grab the ledge. You can just simply do a standing jump, which didn't work. Okay, there you go, just jump and grab and then shimmy all the way as far as you can. So it can be a bit odd the way she does this. So as far as you can, you want to climb up. You might need to just run forward or you might actually just slide straight on in to the secret. So be sure to keep pressing forward as you climb up because that's a funny angle, that one. To get out of here, just jump forward, then hop back and grab. There we go. So this is where I'm going to end the video. So I hope you're enjoying Aqua Sanctuary so far, and I'll see you in part 2. Thanks a lot. Take it easy, guys.